So iOS 11 includes the brand new Files app. Now this app is kind of similar to the previous iCloud Drive app that came with iOS 10. We'll find it here in the dock, but you may find it up in regular icons on your home screen depending upon how you have things arranged. This is what it looks like. So basically you have a sidebar on the left and you have folders on the right. Now this app looks very similar to basically using the Finder on your Mac, but it combines some other elements as well, like elements from Preview in addition. So let's take a look at what we've got. On the left here we have sources of things, so locations it's called. So we have iCloud Drive. Also, if you have apps that are storing things locally, documents locally, not on iCloud Drive, you'll see local documents there as well. Or it's called just on my iPad. And also Dropbox. Now how did Dropbox get there? That's third party. That's not an Apple thing. It got there because the Dropbox app is installed and I've logged in using that app. So now I can access my Dropbox files here as well. The same thing is true with other apps as well. Like for instance, Google Drive. If you have that installed, that would be available there on the left. I can hit Edit at the top and I can add new ones. So you can see the Documents app, another third-party app, actually has the hooks to go into this Files app here. So I could turn that on if I want. And any others that I would hook in with the Files app would also appear there as well. So it depends on what you have installed. So let's take a look here. If we look at these folders just going into them, we just, you know, tap on them. So let's go into the Documents there and I've got some files. Now what can I do with these? Well, I can view standard files. So image files I just tap on and now I'm viewing them inside of this Files app. The same could be done for other standard file types. So for instance like PDFs. So I have some PDFs here and I can view them. Now here's where it gets to be even more like Preview. Not only can you preview things like images and PDFs, but I can mark them up. So I've got markup buttons on the upper right, that markup button right there, and now I can draw on the PDF, change colors, and do some basic stuff like that. I have undo buttons at the bottom. I've got a plus button at the right and I can add text, signature, shapes. So very similar to using Preview. I can hit Done and I can go back in anytime I want and work with those. So elements of Preview in there as well. And you can add, look at text files here too. There's not much you can do. You can't actually edit the text file. So kind of like Preview as opposed to text edit. You can mark things up but you can't necessarily edit them. Notice here when I scroll down I got sorting options at the top. I can sort by name, date, size, tags. I can go list view. I can use that folder button there to create a new folder and give it a name and it sticks it there. So I've got the ability to do that. I can search. I have a search box there at the top and it searches by name so it doesn't search inside the files, I don't believe. Maybe that will come in the future. I can look at other file types as well. Here's some audio files and all of these work and these are various different formats. And I can, you know, play those files. Same thing with video. I've got video files here and I can actually play the video inside of the Files app. I'm not going into another app. And anytime I'm doing this I can use the share button from any of these for the video, for the audio, for PDFs, and I can share so I can send email, I can do, you know, other things with them. So there's a lot you can do. Now you can also work with files in a more standard sense, like say rename them. So like let's take this image file here. I'll tap and I'll hold and I'll get copy, duplicate, rename, move, delete, share, and then I can add tags and I can even get info on the file. So you can get info there. So very much like the Finder on Mac. Tags allows me to add different tags. I can add like a red tag to this and then the tags on the left here I can go in and I can see things that have been tagged. I can also make things, add things to favorites. So for instance if I'm using this document folder a lot I can drag it over to favorites there and now I can jump right to documents anytime I want. I don't have to dig down inside of iCloud Drive to get to it. You can select multiple files at the same time Let's go back to icon view here. I can select this, and as soon as I start moving around I can now tap another file, and now I have two that are selected. So I can use the drag and drop functionality to, you know, take it to some other place move them around in here. Now you can also go and select and then select multiple ones there. So hitting that select button or select all, and then you have buttons at the bottom like share, duplicate, move, delete, all there at the bottom. So share will only work if I don't have those folders selected, and I could do that right from the bottom there. So you have multiple ways of doing things, which is also a lot like the Mac Finder. There are also some other things I want to show you. Archive. I've got a zip archive. So you can actually view zip archives. Go in, it tells you it's how big it is. There's three files. I can go preview, and I can see there's an image and there's a text file. So I can flip between the items in here, and I can even mark them up, but I could also share them out. So if I wanted to get export this image from this zip archive, I could do that. I could do save image here, or I can do copy, or I could do save to files. So I can put it in my documents folder. So you have that ability to do it. So there it is. So you can extract things from zip archives, which is pretty advanced functionality as well. So there's a lot of really cool things that you could do. You can view, you can see on the left there, there's a trash for recently deleted. So it's kind of the same thing as a trash can. You can view at the bottom there, it says browse, and there's also recents. I can switch to recents and see the recent files. So as soon as I add some files to it, I can see them here. I can also share files here using the new iCloud Drive functionality. It's also going to be available in macOS Sierra. So I can go to documents and say I want to share this file right here. I can go into it. This is just one way of doing it. And I can hit share, and you can see add people. And add people allows me to go ahead and invite people or create share options like anyone with a link can view this. So you can do the new share functionality right from in this Files app. So it's really handy, and you also see elements of this Files app in other apps. When you go to access files on iCloud Drive, you'll be able to actually get a little mini version of this Files app that allows you to go in. Just like you get a mini version of the Finder when you go to open a file inside of an app on the Mac. So check it out. Play around with it. There's a lot of ins and outs and things to take a look at here with the new Files app, and it looks a little different on the iPhone as it does on the iPad, but the basic functionality is the same.